Right, the Rockish Record, the track of the week. This week comes from Angels and Airwaves. The track is All That's Left Is Love. I decided to give frontman Tom DeLonge a bell, see what's going on in his world in this current situation, find out a little bit about the track. Here's what he had to say.
Hello.
Hello.
Is this Dan?
It is Dan. How are you?
Good. Are we just doing audio or are we doing video too?
Just audio. I mean, I can send you a picture of my face if you like.
Nah, I'm okay. I'm going to imagine you as just a beautiful young man, handsome and cocksure.
Thanks. How you doing anyway? You okay?
Yeah, no, I'm good. I'm at, I have a cabin in the mountains and I'm at it right now. So I'm very happy with what I'm looking at right now.
Yeah, that rules. It's a weird time, man.
I know. It really is. And it's something I've never seen in my entire life. And I don't know anybody else has seen anything like this. So, you know, it's going to take a minute to figure it all out. That's for sure.
Yeah. I saw that the proceeds for this single are going to be going to the charity Feeding America.
Yes. I've worked with Feeding America for a while now. I've done a lot of different things with them. I've done everything from going to schools and handing out food to underprivileged children. I've gone to certain centers on holidays, Christmas and so on. And my daughter has done a lot of community service time, you know, pick, pack, and ship to get the food, the meals ready for underprivileged families. And they're also from San Diego, and I'm good friends with a few people that are deeply involved with that organization. So I think a lot of people tend to think that, you know, countries such as, you know, places like the UK or the United States or whatever, like, we, you know, we're a well-off country. We do compared to other countries, but there still are a lot of people that live in poverty in these places. So this is something that was right in my backyard. It was something that I knew was super important for what it's doing right now for people that don't have jobs and that have lost everything. This provides a tiny bit of stability in those difficult times. So it was a very easy decision to team up with them. I've done it before, and I love what they're doing, and they're more needed now than ever. So I look forward to being able to help in the little way we can.
Yeah, I agree. This single is obviously the third one after Rebel Girl and Kiss and Tell, but tell me a little bit more about the Angels album.
Yeah, so, well, I've been recording for about a year, if not longer, taking my time up until recently, and now we're, like, pounding away like crazy, but really, so Kiss and Tell, Rebel Girl was a single. Kiss and Tell was not. It was just something we wanted to put out as we went into our tour. And yeah. So we made a video for it, and it was just, we wanted to play a new song, and that was one that was ready. So we put it out, but it was not a second single. And then this one's not a single either. It happened to be all recorded. I just needed to sing it. And I realized, I was obviously, like everyone else, I was really inspired to do something that mattered. Because the last thing I want to do is, you know, I don't want to wait another year before I put out music because of the COVID virus, you know. So I wanted to put something out. But Angels and Airwaves is always done. I mean, one thing, if anything, to our fault, to a fault, is, you know, we've always been full of hope and love and consciousness and awareness. And that's kind of something that we've been doing since day one, 13 years ago.
Yeah.
And so it made a lot of sense for us to do this. Putting out this song with, you know, dealing with trying to lift people's spirits right now is just, like, so tried and true what the band is all about. So I just went in and saying the words that came to my heart, and here we have something that I think is, I don't know, I'm pretty proud of it, you know, I'm excited for it. It pulls on the heartstrings for what people are going through, and, you know, the words say the world is different now, and we feel more of us, you know, even though this place is a mess, we always pass the test, you know, and when you feel like looking up when the days are getting tough, a little bit's enough when all that's left is love. And I feel it's true. Like, when everything's gone, when everything's stripped away from you, the only thing that you have that matters is the connection you have with the people around you and what you've done for them personally, for their, you know, their hearts and minds, and how you've helped them. And I find a lot of people that are depressed and in a really bad place. One of the best things you can do is help other people. It will always lift your own spirits to get out there and give, you know? And so I don't know, that's what I'm thinking. That's where I'm coming from.